My mind's been running in circles this week. I've been trying to piece this all out again, for you know I'm a patient one, but there's so much at stake.
Hello everyone, Meg here from Pmtvuk UK, and today we've been hanging out at Headstock in Birmingham, the home of Laney Amplifiers. And I thought this would be a good opportunity to take a look at the Audiohub range of speakers or combo amps. And if you aren't familiar with them, then introduce you to some super portable and very, very capable speakers that come in all sizes from 5 watts up to 300 watts.
My mind's made up on you.
Now, I'm sure many of you guitarists watching will be familiar with Laney amplifiers, and you will know them for their big guitar combos and their epic sound. One thing you might not think of them with doing is keyboards, electric drums and guitars, things along this line. Well, this is where the Audiohub speakers come into play. There's often times where if you are playing, like myself, as a solo or duo musician and you don't want to carry around a big PA system, 2 speakers or a big column array, but you need something for your gigs, then something that can cater to all of your instruments is going to be preferable. The main premise behind bringing these amps out to the world was having an amplifier that could do everything in one. Whether you are an acoustic guitarist, a keys player, electric drums, or maybe you're even just playing music through your speaker and you want to be able to do it all from one speaker, then the Audiohubs are perfect for that. You'll know if you've ever played around with acoustic guitar amplifiers, electric amps, bass amps, they are very catered and tailored to that specific instrument. So putting a keyboard through an electric guitar amp is probably not going to sound the best, and vice versa, the other way around with other instruments. So if you are a gigging artist, something that can be really useful is a compact and portable system that you can do everything from. Now, I will go through the range. As I said, they start at 5 watts and they finish at 300. So depending on what you're looking for, one of these is probably going to cater to your needs most. But starting right at the end, looking at the 5 watt, this is the AH-Freestyle. This particular amplifier would be perfect if you are looking for something to busk with. This is the only one in the whole range that is battery powered as well as mains powered. So this really opens up the possibilities for using this speaker if you are a busker or someone who is looking to play outdoors for whatever reason, or have a easy to carry portable speaker for your rehearsals with your solo or duo setup. On this speaker, you do have 3 inputs. So you have 1 mic input and 2 jack or line inputs. You have digital delay on there, so something that's quite fun to apply to your guitar if you're looking to bigger the sound a little bit if you're playing solo. This all comes on this 1 5-watt speaker. It may be quiet, but it's gonna be perfect for those smaller outdoor busking setups where you need a battery powered speaker. This lends me on nicely to the 2 beside it, the 40 watt and the 80 watt. In terms of features, these 2 are pretty much the same, but with the 80 watt, obviously you have more output, more power, and a slightly bigger woofer inside, so more bass response. What you'll be looking to use these for will depend which one you go for, of course, but I would say these 2 speakers are going to be perfect for those smaller indoor solo or duo gigs. So just like the smaller amp, you have 1 mic input and 2 jack or line inputs. So you could use this for guitar, keyboard, electric drums, or anything that requires a line input. This would be cool if you are in a duo and say there is a keys player, a vocalist, and a guitarist, then you can all go into the same system, which is gonna make this nice and easy to use. The only key difference between the 40 and the 80, other than volume, is the 80 comes with that digital delay. So if you are after something that's going to have a bit more you can do for your guitar sound, then I would have a look at the 80 watt version and have a play around with that digital delay. If you've never experimented with pedals or delay before with your acoustic guitar, this is a whole other world to enter, but it's something that can make your guitar tone sound quite exciting compared to just a flat piezo going into a speaker system. As these speakers can be propped up as a wedge as well, there is always the option to use one of these speakers as a wedge monitor on stage. Something that I've seen some of my fellow musicians do with these exact speakers is have them as their stage monitor. This can make your gigging setup quite simple and easy to use, as these are very lightweight, they're very portable, but it means you could have two of these on stage as your band's wedge monitor setup and you're going to hear really well as having some EQ so you can perfectly suit the sound of what's coming into you on stage. So these are the smaller ones, and you want to consider what place you'll be gigging in, what size the venue and how big the crowd as to which one you will go for. If you are looking for something that kicks out a bit more volume, then I would take a look over at the 150 watts or the 300 watts. Now, Laney's cite themselves that the 150 should be enough for a medium-sized venue. So I would think something like a 100 capacity venue or a small bar or a club somewhere where you'll be paying to around 100 to 150 people. And the 150 watts should pump out enough power and enough volume to cover your sound. With this one, you have five inputs. So you have two XLR and line inputs, as well as two additional line inputs and an aux input. This of course means you could put music through if you were looking for any backing tracks or music to go in between your songs in your set. With this, you of course have that five band EQ and the digital delay is on there too. Another interesting thing to note about these speakers is they have a line out, a jack line out. So if you do need more volume from this speaker, then you can send it straight out to the desk and it's really easy. As this speaker has five inputs, this means essentially you could get your whole band into one system if you are looking for a very portable and easy to carry solution for your smaller to medium gigs. I know how much of a pain it can be to load in your whole rig into a car, especially if there's only three of you and it's a particularly small venue that you're loading into. So this would be a really good solution. If you know that this isn't going to be enough volume, then this is where the 300 watt version would come in. This has everything that all of the others have, but you have additional effects on board, reverb, delay and chorus, which you can switch between. So reverb you can apply to the vocal channel, of course, and if you are looking to enhance your guitar sound, then you've got delay and chorus on there, which you can switch between. Still got those five inputs, so you can get your whole band in if you wanted to, and it'll have a line out, so if you wanted to send this out to a desk for extra volume or connect it up to an additional speaker, there is a speaker output on the back. There's so much you could do with this one speaker. You could even double up if you wanted to and have two of the same pumping out for extra volume at your gig. And just the same with the smaller speakers, if you did need a wedge monitor on stage, then these would work perfectly well and would have even more bottom ends, so might be particularly useful for a bass player or a drummer who's looking for some good fallback coming through when they're playing the set. Essentially, these speakers from the offset might look like a standard speaker, but there's a lot you can do with these, and if you aren't familiar with them, it's definitely a range that you'll want to check out and go and have a listen to. I would highly recommend, if you are a keys player, play electric drums or anything of this sort, having a go with this speaker and seeing how it sounds. I think you're often up against it with some of these instruments in finding an accessible and affordable option for amplifying your keys or your drums. So looking at these might be a really good option for those particular instruments, as well as of course the acoustic guitar and vocals combo that will often be going into a portable system like this. I think the real test is to have a play through them though. I play acoustic and sing, so of course that's the setup I'm going to try today. We're going to have a play around and work with the EQ a little bit, add some reverb to the vocals and guitar, and we're going to try the loudest and the quietest option to see what these speakers can do. Hopefully it will come across to you how much you can get out of these systems.
Life comes in seasons. What is gone is in the past. Life has no reason to keep going. It's all of these late nights walking and all of these midnights talking. They're bringing me closer to your heart.
That was a quick overview of the Laney Audiohub range of speakers. If you weren't familiar with them, then hopefully this can introduce you to them. And if you did want to find out any more information about any of these or have a try of them yourself, all the details will be in the description box, so you can click through to the website and have a look. It's also always worth popping into your local store, as your ears are the best test for this. So if you can plug into them and have a go, then that will be the best way to hear it for yourself. I hope you found this useful and have enjoyed this video. If you have, hit that like button and subscribe to the channel. You can also catch us on socials at Play Music Today. My name's Meg, and I will see you all very soon.